Hello everyone, this is Harsha. Welcome to my channel Crypto English. So hi guys, in today's video we'll discuss next project which is going to conduct its IDO on Polka Starter platform, which is Unmarshall. So in today's video we'll discuss what is Unmarshall, and then we'll discuss about the Polka Starter IDO details, then we will discuss its token economics, and finally price prediction. So before starting the video, if you are here for the first time, subscribe to the channel. This is my new channel in English. So I already have two YouTube channels in two Indian languages. So do subscribe to this channel. So if you like the video, click the like button. If you have any doubts or clarification, mention them in the comment section below. So let's begin the video, guys. So guys, first thing, what is Unmarshall? So Unmarshall is a multi-chain DeFi data network, the easiest way to query blockchain data. So this is one DeFi data network. So in simple terms, they are going to build a similar thing which is already available, which is the Graph. So I think everyone who are watching this video already aware of this project, which is the Graph. So this project has been launched its coin in December 2020. It's not even 4 months. So within that short time frame, this particular coin is in the rank of top 50, and it's with $2 billion market cap. So Unmarshall is also providing similar functionalities, similar use cases to B2B, which is providing the DeFi data through simple queries. So that too, one major difference from Graph and Unmarshall is Graph supports only Ethereum platform or Ethereum blockchain, but Unmarshall will support multi blockchains, so which include Ethereum, Binance Smart Chain and Polkadot. And they are going to include three more blockchains, which are Solana, Elrond and Neo. So these six blockchains will be supported for DeFi data extraction, that which is supported by this Unmarshall. So this is very good use case. So compared to Graph, this is having few more additional features. So once they deliver the product which they are promising, this project is going to be a very huge project. So now let's discuss what actually it does. So basically, nowadays extracting information from data is very useful and very important thing, in not only in crypto industry, outside crypto industry also, whichever companies help them do that or having high potential. So same way Unmarshall, what it does is, in blockchain we have so much data which normal user or normal systems or application doesn't understand, which are in encryption, hashes and so on. So now Unmarshall, what they do is, Unmarshall will do indexing to that particular data and extract the information from that data and provide certain APIs to B2B. So basically they are building this solution for B2B, business to business, not to the B2C. So basically this is for B2B. So end users like us may not be using it directly, but indirectly we will be using it. So now I'll explain you how it works. So basically Unmarshall will be providing a bunch of code which are called as APIs. So you can see on the screen on the right side. So these are the API bunch of code which will be used. There are multiple APIs which Unmarshall will be providing. So through these APIs, the application or DApp or wallet or exchange which is using these APIs can use this APIs and extract the data and provide that additional information to their end users. So simple way, for example, building the feature of DeFi. So they have, if a wallet project is developing a wallet, so for providing the user data with the tokens, number of tokens or hold, number of token balances, transaction history and other protocol positions, that can be driven with the APIs which are provided by Unmarshall. So just assume Blank is a recent protocol which is trying to build a privacy wallet. So that Blank protocol, they can use the APIs of which Unmarshall is providing for wallet API services. With those APIs, that Blank protocol can derive those token balances in that particular wallet application. So this is one use case which will be provided for the wallet creators. Then coming to DeFi protocols like Aave, Compound, any other DeFi protocol, these particular APIs which are provided to DeFi protocol will help the DeFi protocol to track the protocol volume, analytics, transaction and other user positions in lending and borrow and liquidity, total value locked. All those statistics can be easily pulled out with the help of this DeFi protocol APIs which provided by Unmarshall. So then coming to the exchanges, so exchanges which are building a decentralized exchange, they can use this Unmarshall APIs and they can they can extract the data which is related to that particular token matrix, token prices, price history, historical data of that particular token. All those things can be extracted and showed into that particular exchange. Then coming to the finally the investor. So investors can have a insights and analytics with a user interface which provided with the dashboard. So investors can create their own dashboard using this bunch of codes. So this is the main four use cases where this unmarshal APIs are used. And then coming to other simple examples, so in this screen you can see this. So it will extract the data from different blockchains, and it will index that particular data and validate those data with the help of the nodes which will be running on unmarshal. And whoever is running the nodes, they will be incentivized with the marsh token. And then once the data is indexed and properly driven, that will be available with unmarshal. And then with the help of the unmarshal APIs and WebSockets, the end user, whoever is a B2B user who are using these APIs, they can extract the data from all these blockchains through this indexing node services. So on the right hand side, you can see basically unmarshal will be providing API services, then WebSockets. I don't think WebSockets are available for the graph on the graph protocol. I think that is also one advantage here. Then push notifications also provided. So when you are doing a transaction in a wallet which is using unmarshal APIs, they can configure some push notifications. For example, your wallet, you are using a SafePal wallet, so you don't get any alerts usually. So with the use of unmarshal APIs, if they are using this particular unmarshal APIs, if you are getting any credit to your wallet address, you will get a push notification onto your mobile. Just imagine that. So I think that is very good use case. So in current scenario, so where private sales are happening, users are unable to track their token credits which are happening time to time. So with this push notification, user will be alerted. So if I am getting any private sale allocation today, I'll get a notification on my mobile stating that so and so tokens have been credited to your wallet address, so and so. So that also gives a very good use case. This push notification functionality also not available in graph currently. So I think this is also one game changer. Then they also provide GraphQL. So GraphQLs are basically query languages on APIs. So basically extracting data, they'll be using GraphQLs, and then insights and other analytics. So these are the major functionalities which will be provided by unmarshal and their APIs and web services. So I think this is going to be a very huge project. So my favorite one is the push notification. So I wanted that to be implemented in all the wallets which I'm using in decentralized exchanges. So this is a complete project review. So basically if you see the roadmap, so roadmap is also very interesting, and so there are many events coming before Q3 of this year. So I think by Q3, if they deliver what they are promising, I think this project is going to be a very huge project. Then coming to the team, the main founder and CEO is Manohar. So the entire team is from India, and I think it's a very good team. So they have very good experience, past experience in blockchain and other developments as well. So now that is all about unmarshal project. So now let's jump into the token sale. So before going to the token sale, they have raised around $2.6 million worth of fundraising in strategic rounds, and there are many major VCs who have invested, including BitMEX. So maybe BitMEX may list this particular unmarshal token on their exchange. Then coming to the Polka Starter whitelist. So Polka Starter, the IDO will be conducted on the Polka Starter platform. So which will be on 30th March. Each token price will be priced at $0.17, and total fundraise is around $204,000, and each individual cap is $300,000 per account. So this is very, very interesting. So now we'll discuss the token economics and discuss the price prediction. So coming to the token economics, so this is also a very interesting token economics in recent times. So I'll tell you why. So private rounds which are conducted are seed and privates. So both the rounds tokens released on TG will be 10% and 15% respectively. After this TG event, there will be 4 months lock-in period. So until 4 months, there won't be any further tokens released from seed and private rounds. So this will increase the this will reduce the chances of pre-sale dumps, and in my point of view, this will also pull the price very, very high. So that is also a good indicator. After 4 months lock-in period, there is a 9 months vesting period. So very long vesting for a private investor, and this is very good for public sale investor which have 0% lock-in period. So let's calculate the initial circulating supply and initial market cap. So first thing, seed round, they have around 5 million tokens multiplied by 0.1, which is 10% release on the token generation event, which will be 0.5 million circulating supply from seed round. Then let's calculate the private round. So private round, there are total 12 million tokens which will be available in that 0.15, which is 15% of the tokens will be released on the token generation event, which is 1.8 million. So plus 0.5, which was from the seed round, then add it with the public sale token. So public sale, there will be around 1.2 million tokens in circulation. So 1.2 million. So total circulating supply from private and public sale round will be 3.5 million tokens in circulation. And then let's calculate the market cap. So 3.5 million multiplied by $0.17, which is the token price during the IDO. So total market cap is less than $600,000. So in my point of view, this project is having a high potential, so it can easily do 20x as well. So because Graph is a similar having a similar functionality, is having a $2 billion market cap, and it's way lesser than Graph's market cap. So that is one good thing. So I didn't calculate the other tokens which are coming from the ecosystem marketing team and all. So if we calculate that and include those tokens as well, including liquidity, the initial market cap will be less than $1 million, sitting at around $800,000 to $900,000. That is even that is also at a decent price. So I think this particular project is having a huge potential. So whatever they are promising, if they are delivering and if they are doing huge partnerships with huge DeFi projects on these three blockchains, I think this is going to be a game changer. So that's all, guys. That's all about Unmartial token sale. So definitely submit your whitelisting form. So once you select shortlisted in whitelisting form, you, if you are shortlisted in lottery, you will be able to buy these tokens with an individual cap of $300 on 30th March on Polkastarter platform. So that's all, guys. That is all about Unmartial and its token sale on Polkastarter platform. So if you like the video, if you have gained any good knowledge by watching this video, do subscribe the channel, click the notifications. If you have any doubts or clarification, mention them in the comment section below. So that's all, guys. Thanks for watching. Jai Hind.